when we write the history books about the internet. I think it will go, the internet was started, we invented the World Wide Web, and then we invented blockchain. I spent most of my childhood running around in the forest. I got into becoming a biologist and got my PhD in biodiversity informatics, which is this combination of big data and trying to solve problems that are arising in the real world. I think that the most important thing that nature gives me is a perspective on the importance of every moment that we have living here on doing things that are important for very long timescales.
My background is actually in mapping, and a lot of the work there is around how do people perceive, explore, and understand their environments. And those same kinds of principles actually do apply when you're talking about the internet and communication. How do people extend their everyday interactions into this digital space? We've got information tied up in different platforms, focused on different things that can't be used together. And what that leads to is highly siloed pieces of your digital self. What this ends up leading to is like very strong network effects, which from the perspective of a business is great because it basically means you need to come to me in order to get what you want. But it's not great for the consumer. Web3 promises a whole different ballgame where user control is at the forefront.
When we started focusing on Web3, we were really curious about what it could change around personal data on the web. And we started thinking what applications of personal data could be built using the technologies of Web3, things like IPFS and Filecoin. And we realized that photos was a really interesting use case. The reason photos are interesting is because, unlike most personal data, people get it. People intuitively get why you want privacy. They get why you want ownership. And so we decided to build a really simple use case on Web3 technologies. We used that as almost like a field study.
We learned how difficult that process was, and we realized we really needed to build the underlying technologies to make it easier for other developers to build these, you know, engaging, useful experiences on Web3 technology.
Right now at Textile, we really focus on building suites of tools that developers can just grab and plug into the applications they're already building or the application that they want to build and get the benefits of decentralized communication, end-to-end encryption, cryptographically verified storage, really interesting and new concepts that we want developers to play with. Evolution is really slow. We can have an idea go viral in humanity overnight. That's happening at a speed that evolution could never happen at. And so we can actually build technology really fast. We can explore ideas really fast. We can let tests run and succeed or fail really fast and select for really good ideas really quickly. But it takes open systems. It takes open flow of information. It takes connecting ideas freely. Data has gravity because it's been shown to create so much value for the organizations that are collecting it. And because of that, they built this big silo around the data. And the direct consequences that has on us are that you don't get a say what happens to that data after it's there. You don't get to get it back out. And there's only one place you can use that data, and that's in the applications of the organization that built the silo. And what we're proposing is a system where individuals can have the silo, where I can actually have my data and I can control where it's going.
Imagine a scenario where from day one I install an app and it's already populated with the data and information and interactions with my friends from previous apps and experiences. From a developer's perspective, now I can actually compete with incumbents who already have all of the network effects in place. So I can actually release a new app with a great new experience, and I don't have to worry that I don't have users yet because my users will bring the data with them. We just haven't even seen the tip of the iceberg yet. I'm really excited for the technologies that just couldn't have existed 5 years ago, couldn't have existed 2 years ago, because we just haven't pushed the technology to its limit yet. And that's a big piece of what Textile is doing.